Hi, welcome to my channel, the Machine Learning Engineer. Today, I will speak about parameter efficient fine-tuning PEF. While this video is included on the series Prone Engineering, this is not really a prone engineering technique, as we saw in part 1 and part 2 of this tutorial. It's more prone fine-tuning is a way that they fine-tune a model using a dataset, a specialized model, but this way we use a library which will help us to efficiently save memory and get the similar outcomes to what we get fine-tuning the model with the dataset of prompts. I will explain you now how it works. We just continue with the same data set that we use in before from prompt tuning. We are using, need to remember, the Dialogsun data set. We are using a Flantified base model as foundational model. This is the model that we are going to train and is fine-tune, sorry, and specialize for dialog summarization. Again, parameter efficient fine-tuning is a technique which essentially reduce the number of parameters that we are going to finally train during the fine-tuning process. And in few words, what we are doing is defining freezing the parameters of the model, in this case of the Flantified, and defining a matrix with a small two matrix which essentially are going to be to replace in terms of size, or be an equivalent in terms of size of the parameters of the layer that is going to replace. Usually we replace linear layers. You can essentially replace any layer, attention layers, feed-forward layers, but usually just training or replacing the linear layers with these two matrices. I will explain you now how it's done is enough, no? And well, this way allow us, you remember in the previous tutorial where we do prompt fine-tuning, we use a Flantified base which had around about 250 million tokens, sorry, 250 million parameters. And in the case of the prompt fine-tuning, we just use all the parameters in the model to train using a GPU, conventional GPU, where we are continue using Colab Pro with a A100 with 40 gigabits. It was enough, probably even too much. We can do that fine-tuning with a T4, but in this case we were fine-tuning, we use all the parameters available on the model, in this case 247 millions, practically 248 millions of parameters, and all of them were fine-tuned and used during the fine-tuning. Using PET will allow us, as you will see, as we use a percentage very very small, less than some cases depending on the rank value. I will explain right now what's mean rank. We will use a very low percentage of the available parameters on the model in comparison with the original ones. So in this case, as you will see, depending of the RAM parameters, I will explain right now what is the number of the reduction is practically 90-95% reduction on the number of the trainable parameters that you are going to train during the fine-tuning. So PEF is just the concept, and then on there is two implementations that is probably what you probably know, LoRa and QLoRa. They are the same. The only one that different is that in QLoRa you use quantized values, usually integer 8 or integer 4. And essentially the concept is exactly the same. You take a matrix, you choose a rank. A rank is a value which explained here. It refers to the maximum number of linear independent columns or rows in the weight matrix that you are going to replace, and usually it's a value that in the range in between 4 to 16. As lower the rank, more less parameters you are going to train, and values about 16 is already, well, some researchers have already concluded that there is no how to say improvement in the performance having values above 16. So researchers in some papers recommend to use values in between 4 to 16. And how this really works? Well, you choose a rank, and then let's imagine that we had this system matrix that we want for what we want to replace with these two matrices, and as you see, they had two dimensions, 64 by 512, and then we will replace this. We will freeze in the original model the original layer. In this case, could be again a linear layer, a feed forward layer, whatever. You freeze and you replace this with two matrices. One is a matrix that will have a dimension of 64 by 4, which is a rank of 4, and the other matrix is 512 by 4. So this means that the amount of the trainable parameters after this replacement, it will be 4 by 64 is 256 parameters, and the other matrix X, matrix B, 500, matrix is 256, matrix B is 512 by 4, total 2040. In total, we replace this matrix of 32,768 parameters with a two matrix out, that in total are 2,304 parameters. So those are the parameters that we are going to train, and after the process, once we say this trained by parameters, these matrices replace a number of the layers. You can replace all. Usually we replace also there is some research paper that demonstrate that only replacing the linear layers is more than enough, and again with a ramp RAM value in between 4 to 16, and only with that you generate another weights that later on you are going to merge with the original pre-trained weights that come, for example, in this case on the Flantify base. Again, QLoRa is just a variant of the LoRa, but using here we combine the efficiency in parameters with using these two, replacing some layers or some layers on the model with these two matrices, with using at the same time quantization, using either 4-bit quantization or normal float NF4 or 8-bit quantization. So we reduce not only the number of trainable parameters, we also use the amount of memory that each parameter uses. This is the quantization part, no? Here I give you as well an example, a very good example, but for somebody who did it with the Flantify XXL in a GPU A100 with 80 gigabytes. This parameter had 11 billion of parameters, and you can see like in a, well, it's not conventional because, well, a 800 with 80 gigabytes is not usually a GPU that you use on domestically. you can see that at home. It's a very expensive hardware, but well, it's still using just one GPU in that case. They are training a model with 11 billions. You can also train models with 13 and even a little bit higher with just a single GPU. And if you just sign together in this process, this person didn't use Coolora, also only use LoRa. If you also use quantization, is able to with this GPU even possible to train even biggest model like a Falcon or something similar. To be clear here, I keep using just continue with the same tool I used during all these tutorials, Colab Pro with A100, but you will see now that due to the reduction of the parameters, I will be able to train this in my computer, which has a simple NVIDIA 1640 with 4 gigabytes of memory. It's perfectly possible. Next topic to discuss also again, well, the LoRa is one of the parameters that we apply to the LoRa config. LoRa config is part of this library. Sorry, I didn't mention that. I posted here the link to the first of all the link to the which describes the process. Here is the process, the link to the paper that describes LoRa in particular, and here is the link to the repository of the library that we are going to use. It's very well explained what they do. They apply not only LoRa, these other variants that you can apply with this library. You can go in details. All of these are research papers which explain the details of this variants of this technique, and well, several cases fine-tuning different kinds of the models and all the details you can find here. And well, even they give details about the accuracy that they get using this technique, that there is practically no reduction on that. And well, it's a small reduction, but well, the trade-off is that you can train or fine-tune in any case very big models using conventional hardware, not hyper expensive hardware that is not at hand, not many even companies with a very big budget. So you reduce considerably time and infrastructure needed to fine-tune a model, which at the end is feasible for many companies. Even as I said, in some cases like here, even in a conventional GPU at home, you can do it. And then on part of the LoRa configuration is the LoRa config, which in this experiment I run had some minimum values you need to set up. Here on that we import the libraries we need. Here is just configuring this class with all the parameters we need either to train the model and also to configure the LoRa process. So we have the rank. Alpha, that is an scaling factor for the weight matrices. RAN is the dimension of the low RAN matrices, is the parameter I explained you before. Tax type, in this case I will apply the sequence to sequence. It's one of the tasks available, is conventional tax defining in Hugging Face. This is the same nomenclature. Then on here, important thing, target values. Target values, usually this is going to change depending on the model. And I'm not 100% sure, but I read somewhere that they are going to introduce a value that specify all linear layers with a single parameter. But to my knowledge, you need to understand, you need to localize at to now manually the name of these linear layers that you want to optimize or you want to replace for the rank matrices. So in the case, for example, of the flan T5 or the T5 series, is these layers which had the query and value tags. But in the case, for example, of Llama 2, these linear layers are Q-projection, K-projection, B-projection, and O-projection. Again, this is depending on the every architecture, the architecture you are going to use. Just review, there is plenty of the scripts available in internet to just localize these layers. And I need to read this. I will post it probably at the end. I will find exactly the documentation, but I already read that the PEP library already contain this just in target module apply all linear and they automatically will find all the linear layers and it will apply the replacement during the training process. For now, I just set up this with the conventional, the old style or the tags that I apply to the linear layers in the architecture flantified. Don't apply vias. Well, like here I put and LoRa dropout, which is a dropout rate as in a conventional dropout layer. We apply the parameters to the LoRa config object, and here with this other function of the library, get path model, we just apply the original model, which is the T5 and the LoRa configuration. And here just we use the same method that I prepared before for the prone instruction fine-tuning model, which contains 100 millions, and you will see here that we have now 251 millions. This is the layers that we replace are in total 3 millions 538, 539 almost parameters. This is the trainable parameters, and in total now. So the original model, that remember, that was 248 almost millions, plus the 3 millions that we add for due to the replacement of this K matrix that we introduce. In total, now we have 251 millions. And if you see now, the reduction in number of parameters that we are going to train is 1.40, which is a huge reduction. So this means that now these 3 millions of parameters can fit on my conventional GPU, and even don't need to use the 100 because this is feasible to be run in my conventional desktop. For the rest, well, we create the training argument object. This is exactly the same that in the previous exercise for prompt fine-tuning. We create the trainer exactly the same, but here we send the PEP model, and we use the same dataset and the same validation dataset. We train the model. This is not changed. I'm using as well here, like in the previous exercise, 1 dB for logging and keeping all track of the whole experiment and also keeping the artifacts I produce. I take the best model as we had the setup load the best model at the end of the training process. We save the model and I save later on the model here to 1 dB. Later, I load the model. First of all, how to load now the model? As you remember, we need to merge the new PEF trained parameters, merge these parameters together with the original ones. This is exactly what we are doing here. We take the base model, just loading the Flan T5 base. We load the tokenizer. The tokenizer is not changing, and here using a PEF model from the library, from pre-trained, we just take the base model and the weights learned on the training process, and we merge it with this with this method, load it in BrainFlow 16, and we put the model in not trainable mode, in evaluation mode, in few words. Here we have the model, and we run the evaluation. Here just we do the same test that in the previous tutorial, with the same examples, and we see now we have the baseline. This is the summary that make the human. This is one shot prompting using with the original Bestified. This is structure model, and this is PET model. And we load this to 1 dB. Now we do the evaluation using Roach, and you can see here down the output. So the original model, 0 shot, get 37. With the PET model, we get slightly better in all the measures that we take: Roach 1, Roach 2, Roach L, and Roach L-sum. All of them are slightly better than the original one. I don't know exactly what this something probably I had a bug somewhere else, because these measures also were slightly better than the zero shot. So at the end, the difference in between PET, you can observe that there is no, practically no difference in between using prone extraction with all the parameters and using PET. It's slightly less, usually slightly less performant, but practically imperceptible. If you look at the example I mentioned before, or I got you before, these pair people with a Flan T5 XXL, they are getting rows of 50 somewhere else. Let me scroll down. They write somewhere else. Evaluate, blah blah blah. Let me say, because they are, yeah, exactly. Rows 150 and test 47.23. So the improvement using obviously Flantify XSL, as we say, is 11 million parameters. But well, we can train it. If I don't remember wrong, this took me like 1 hour 30 minutes or 1 hour 29 minutes to train the to fine tune this model, and using instruction it was practically 2 hours. So we spent less time, and well, the reduction in performance is practically nothing. So most of the people you are using these techniques, as well, you spend less time, and you can train even bigger models using these techniques. So there is no real reason to fine tune a model or say prone extraction, prone fine tuning, sorry. Okay, and that's all. I will post the tutorial, so the notebook, in the description of this video, and hope that you enjoy and you learn at least how this is work. You can see here also the improvements of the model. Yeah, here we have it, the PET, and yeah, that's all. If you like it, give me a like, and if you didn't subscribe still and not subscribe to the channel, I will be posting soon more interesting videos about how to work with LLMs and how you can optimize them. Thank you for watching. Thank you. Bye.